Man, you get 150 starfish a day in this game, and that's good, but there's so much shit to spend it on. I mean, black market, cooking, capture, storage, skills. It's like, I don't know what I'm doing. I just wish there was somebody, man, somebody who could just help me out.
Fear not, young one.
God? Is that you?
It is I, the great almighty dollar, coming here to tell you the best way to spend your pearls and your starfish.
Sup, everybody, and welcome back to another video. And hey, if you're new here, hi, I'm Tectone. Subscribe, please. Thanks. All right, next. All right, so what are we talking about today? What are we talking about? What we're talking about is we're talking about starfish and pearls, the premium currency of this game. And what I mean by premium is pearls can only be acquired via spending. Speaking of which, don't look at the top of my game. Trust me, I'm free to play, guys. Obviously not. On this account, at least, on my other accounts, I am. But starfish are given organically. You get them every single day. But you only get a little bit, unless the server crashes, which please God, hey, crash more, I want more free starfish, right? I mean, what did we get, like 200 the other day for free? It was pretty dope. So, let's talk about the best way to spend it, because you don't want to mess up when you're spending these, and we're going to rank every single way of spending out of 10, and we're going to go through every single option. If I do miss an option, let me know in the comments, but I've spent a lot of time on this one, and also, if you want to argue my rating system, feel free to in the comments below. Let's get into it, huh? Okay, so the first thing of spending that I want to talk about is the capture accelerant. In case you don't know what that is, you put down a tray of food and then you can press this accelerate button. Do I want to spend 24 pearls or 24 starfish on accelerating this and speeding up 4 hours? No, I don't. And the reason why I don't want to do that is I'm going to get the end goal regardless. It's going to happen regardless if I'm just a little bit patient. Now, the other reason why this is worse is because this is not a for sure increased speed of speeding this process up. And what I mean by that is you still have to have the resource in order to continue cooking right after, which is you have to keep on having the recipes to cook to actually put here. And that's a very finite resource. So I don't want to speed up that process because then I have to find more food. And so I'm realistically spending to have to get food quicker, and that's tough. So no, I mean, while there are some benefits where you start off the game and you get those 3 epic feasts for free, and if you want to pop them back to back to back to back and then get that stuff real quick and then increase your pet training, sure, that is the only scenario where I actually recommend accelerating this, or if you're making a video for YouTube, sure, why not? But other than that, no, I'm gonna give this one a straight up 2 out of 10. It's really not worth it. Okay, next two things we're going to pair into one, okay? So we're talking about tasty fruit and feast capture. So what tasty fruit does is it takes whatever recipe that you're going to cook, and then you'll put a tasty fruit inside of it and make it so it's top class, like the best food that you can get, and it'll guarantee you rares and above. And that's actually quite good because this is 980 starfish. Yes, this can also be purchased with starfish, but it won't display unless you have that mass amount of starfish. So this is actually quite good. The last time I did it, and I've done this 2 times now, and I got 4 epics and a legendary. So the amount that this can actually increase what pets you're getting is quite high, and it has a give and take. So with the actual feast capture, it doesn't require you to have food in order to do it. So it gives you a pet of any category whatsoever. But if you do the tasty fruit capture, then you can actually target what monster or creature you're trying to capture and increase the rates of it being legendary or epic significantly. So yes, I actually like this one quite a lot. I do see how there is some room for debate, but honestly, I would give these a solid 7 out of 10, especially if you're going for fodder and if you just really need a good pet. It's pretty cool. Okay, black market, and this one I've seen get a lot of flack for no reason. Black market, in my opinion, is one of the best ways to spend your starfish and spend your pearls because you cannot put a price on specificity. Knowing what you're getting before you buy it is huge in a gacha game. And this straight up tells you what you're gonna get. 24 starfish for a level 4 defense zone. You know what you get, it's great. Now, refreshing the black market, you can if you like, it's not bad. But as far as buying things in black market, and for real, like Oh my god, the legendary skills you can get, the legendary gear, it's pretty damn cheap in the broad scheme of things. Like, for example, you get 150 starfish a day, you can buy a legendary necklace for a third of what you get in a day, which is pretty damn crazy, and then 1,200 for a legendary skill. That's insane, because I think it's like less than a 1% chance of actually getting that from the actual skill pool. So yeah, black market is crazy good, and I'm gonna give that a solid 8 out of 10. Trust me, black market's great. Just don't go too crazy now. Okay, so skill pulls, and this one is a little bit, it varies, right? Depending on what stage of the game that you're in. And what I mean by that is, the earlier that you do these, the more specific that you can actually be. So a 10 pull at the very beginning would be great, but it depends on what class. If you have an ability that you know you want to have, especially if you're an experienced player and like you're a veteran, you know what abilities work really well on certain classes, which I can make a guide for, by the way, if you request it down in the comments, as for any guide that you want to request in the comments. So I do encourage you to leave a comment. This one gets worse with age, the opposite of a fine wine, if you will. So for example, Warlock has a class or has an ability that they get very early on. It's called like Frog Enhance or something like that, where it extends the duration of your Elder Frog by 6 seconds, and it also hits 3 targets. Now that ability is amazing, and you get that super early in the game. Now the thing about skill pulls is, the less skills that you have in your pool, the more specific you can be. So if you were to use this like the moment you got on the second island, there's only like 8 skills you can get. So this is way better early, and you get a lot of fodder from those skills. So that way you can skill up your actual skill slots. So while this one is a lot better for like maybe the first day or two of the game, later on, if you're finding this video late, maybe like a week or two after launch, chances are you're not really gonna wanna do this too often. I wouldn't really recommend it. So honestly, I'm gonna give skill pulls at the beginning of the game, like for like the first day, probably like a 7 or a 6, but later in the game, probably like a 3 or a 4. So it's just not that good later where I'm already at. Okay, so when you get later in the game, you're gonna unlock an option called Temper. Now you wanna make sure that whatever Temper stat that you get on these weapons is what's going to benefit you the most. Each reroll that you do will actually cost you 20 starfish, or you can also use 20 pearls. Now this one is really up to you. I'm gonna give this one already out of that. I'm gonna give it a ? out of 10, because it depends how hard you wanna push for the rerolls to really min-max your stats. Honestly, I'm gonna do it every day, but I'm not gonna use pearls. I will only use starfish for this, and I'm gonna take it real slow. I'm fine waiting a couple weeks or even a couple months to get the absolute perfect type of stats that I want on my weapon. So it's really up to you how much you want to spend this one. It's impossible to rank, in my opinion, but it is something that you need to do, but it's up to you how fast you want to do it. Next one, a lot of people are sleeping on. So if you click on the little shells that you have in the top right, you'll be prompted with this thing called Shell Goddess Blessing. As you can tell, mine is 50, but for the first one of the day, it only cost you 30 starfish to do. And that one, hey, that's pretty damn good, because it's gonna cost you about 30 starfish to give you a butt ton of shells, which is real, real, real nice. For the very first one for 30 starfish, I feel like that's something you should genuinely do every single day, in my opinion. So I'm gonna give that one, honestly, probably a solid 8 out of 10. It's super good, I highly recommend it, but for things coming after that, I really wouldn't do 50, and nor would I do 100, but yeah, it's really good. I do consider that a daily must. Now, you might be wondering, how could I rank something that is a daily must a 8 out of 10? And I'm going to show you literally the best way. This is the best, bar none, compared to anything else, for how you spend your shellfish and your starfish and your pearls, okay? When you hit level 32, you're going to unlock an option called Explore, and you're going to find this screen, and this screen is amazing. Okay, so what you can do every single day, and you can do this with starfish too, mind you, okay? I have a common. Right now, if I were to do this, I would get 3,200 clams, okay? But if I refresh it, it's going to guarantee me a epic or legendary reward. That's already insane. That takes RNG out of the equation, and this blesses you instantly with great RNG. And now that's insane for a price of 50 starfish, okay? You press confirm, boom, legendary. 38,000 clams by doing that. 50 starfish for 38,000 clams? Yeah, that's pretty good. And if I were to do this, you do quick join, and you can go up to 100% chance to crit And that will give you roughly, I would say, 76,800 clams for 50 starfish. So yes, the refreshing system for Pet Adventure is insane. If you don't know about that, if you did not know about that, hey, leave a like and a comment, because it's pretty damn game-breaking. It is insane. I would be shocked if this does not get nerfed in the near future. So that is the definitive best thing to do with your starfish, in my opinion. Feel free to argue if you like. That's okay. I'm up for debate. Okay, I'm up for debate. Now, those are all of the options for starfish that I know of. Now let's talk about what you can do with your pearls. Once again, this is only what you can do with your pearls, and we're talking quick battle is the first one that I want to talk about. So, the blessing, right? Get 2 hours of progress instantly for yourself and 2 hours of progress for the rest of your team. So in total, 8 hours of progress for free. You can do it once a day, and then it goes to 50, and then you can do 100, and so on and so forth. In my opinion, the free one is amazing, but the 50 one is where we actually start talking about using currency, and that one is pretty damn great. I also consider that a daily must, so I will rank that a 8 out of 10, especially if you're going a little bit hardcore. But hey, the 100 one, the 200 one, the 500 one, I'm not too big a fan of. You can do the 100 if you like. I'd give that a solid 6 out of 10, but anything above the 100, it's just too much. You're very kind if you do it, but it costs so much. I don't really think that it's worth it. If you do it, you're probably going for Pacemaker, or at least the top 99%, but I mean, I would hold on to my pearls. I feel like you can spend them a little bit better. Okay. Last one, and I'm already telling you right now, this is 10 out of 10, the best way to spend your pearls, bar none. Because not only does it help you in game, it also helps you out of game. We're talking gifting, y'all, okay? This is one of the kindest things you can do for anybody, okay? 450 pearls, and you gift a pass to one of your less fortunate friends, okay? So, with this pass, and the one that I would recommend doing is the pet card, okay? So I could gift this to my wife or one of my friends, and this would give them, over the course of the month, around 2,400 pearls. So already you're making about 1,950 pearls net profit to one of your friends, or even better, one of your teammates, which is huge. And this will help them get more pets. It'll let them be able to ride their pet, yada, yada, give you so many rewards. But the gift of giving, and I'm not just saying this, I genuinely love giving more than I love receiving. It's an amazing feeling, and it's gonna help build the community and all that jazz, and help your friends have just as much fun as you're having if you have the luxury of being able to afford to spend premium currency in this game. And once again, this is only attainable by spending actual money on the game. So yes, if you're gonna be able to have a little bit extra pearls laying around, I do highly recommend at least gifting one person a card. It's a great feeling, and it'll really help their gameplay experience accelerate tremendously. All right, y'all, that's gonna do it for this one. Sorry if I got a little bit Father Christmas on y'all, but I hope you enjoyed the video. It was a lot of fun. The intro was a little bit yikes, but you know, whatever, it's fun. Hey, if you made it this far in the video, please consider giving me a subscribe. We're going crazy for the growth right now on the channel. We've gained almost like 700 subscribers since actually starting Ooh La La. We're about to hit 10K, my biggest goal ever since starting YouTube like half a year ago. So hey, 10K subs in 6 months of YouTube, I'm really stoked. I really am so glad that y'all are enjoying the content. And I hope, if you have made this far, once again, I really hope you consider giving me a sub, dropping me a like, and giving me the old comment, letting me know how you feel about the video, and if you had fun. So I'm gonna get out of here. I've been Tecto, and y'all been great. Hope y'all are having a damn good one as always, and peace! Is it